Today we are gonna talk about surrealism. I suppose you have heard about it somewhere from time to time, I hope, because this artistic movement is quite famous. So let us start from really important question: what is surrealism? As of course you might understand, surrealism is yet another art style, or rather art movement, which started in the beginning of 20th century, as well as many other art movements we are talking in these lectures. And this one is special because what it had in mind, what it had in the main idea behind surrealism, was connecting unconscious world with our reality, bringing unconsciousness to the surface. And of course, it was yet another really influential art movement, which left a big, big influence. It made a lot of art. It influenced a lot of other art movements and many artists to work in this style, to think. It actually influenced our culture a lot. So we of course will elaborate on how it made it, but let's come to the beginning of it. And very important question is, when and where started surrealism? So we can trace back the beginning of surrealism. In 1924, when one famous writer, French writer André Breton, had published Surrealism Manifesto, and this way the group was created. It was consisting of a lot of members. Most of them, or all of them, were actually male people, and they were mostly based in France, but also in Belgium. Surrealists lived at that time, and later on it expanded more to the Europe, but however the beginnings lay in France. And as I already told you before, it was not only visual artists, but at the beginning they were writers who were mostly interested in creating surrealism. Only later visual artists joined in. And the main topics and the main ideas, if we talk about surrealism, they talk about bringing up the unconsciousness, our unconsciousness, finding out what's inside of us, what we don't know. And they were really much influenced by works of Sigmund Freud, and they were analyzing and bringing up the fantasies, dreams, stream of conscious, spontaneous thoughts, and it was like a protest against this logical, structural, clear, explanatory nature of traditional artworks. And they would try to erase the boundary between reality and our dreams, and they would try to bring these dreams in front of us, and they would try to create with a special techniques that would enable these unconscious thoughts to come up. And just to give you a short glance of what kind of techniques here we talk about, we must notice that there were two main styles, two main types can be seen. Most important of them were oniric. This is dream-like style, which consisted of kind of realistic shapes, realistically depicted dreamlike forms. And traditionally, when we talk about this style, we keep in mind the Salvador Dalí or René Magritte and early works of Max Ernst, for example. Salvador Dalí got really famous, and probably you know his work. So his style is really realistic, but the objects themselves are created in bizarre way. Other type of depicting things were automatism. And the automatism was especially developed by Max Ernst and Jean Miró. This automatism meant producing automatically the pictures from something, and what you have to keep in mind that those shapes which were created were not reality like. They were strange abstract forms which have no clear beginning and end, abstract lines or something. It's just automatism. You just have to bring out what is inside of you without any consideration, without thinking what can it be. And so when we talk about surrealism, we have to understand, we have to know some visual techniques which they used. For example, one of them, it was very popular, aerography, where spray painting, spraying they were used. And I told you automatic drawing. Where you draw lines just out of your unconscious and just whatever comes to your hand, then it's very common. It was very common to use a collage. This technique when you combine on the paper whatever kinds and bits and pieces of other printed artworks or whatever, or by using this to create a new form. It can also add not only pieces from paper, but also ribbons, other materials. You can paint lacking pieces and so on. Also Cubomania, it's very interesting way of creating art. Is a method where you cut a picture in pieces and use cubes to create new one. Also a lot of beautiful paintings were created by, for example, fumage, when you use a candle and from smoke Photomontage is very, very common technique from surrealists. Also soufflage, when you take the liquid paint and blow it on the paper. Kids like to do it in kindergarten. So that's maybe most important techniques. What else we must know about surrealism? What you have to remember that surrealism, as I told you, it was not only in painting, but also in drawing. In of course they would write very important branch of surrealism, a very important part of surrealism. It was surrealistic films. Among them, the most famous is Chien d'Andalou, Andalusian Dog by Louis Buñuel and Salvador Dalí. From 29, this iconic film, but there were many more. Of course, there were surrealist theater, no surprises, and some music, some composers tried to take up this style, even this is was not that simple. And so altogether, you have to know that surrealism was one of the most influential, up to this day, it's still popular style or movement, art movement, which started in France, and that main idea and main object from this style, main topic in this style, which you have to know, is connecting unconscious world with the conscious, bringing up your subconscious ideas, your dreams, your fantasies into the picture. That's what you should know.